the Great Pyramid of Giza wasn't just built to impress, it was aligned with the stars. But how? And more importantly, why? Long before telescopes or GPS, ancient Egyptians mapped the heavens with astonishing precision. They aligned temples, tombs, and pyramids with celestial events that even modern science is still trying to fully understand. Was it just ritual? Was it divine communication? Or were they encoding secrets into stone secrets we've only begun to decipher? This is the story of how the ancient Egyptians used the stars to build a civilization that would outlive time itself. While most ancient cultures studied the sky, the Egyptians took it a step further. They didn't just observe the stars, they wove them into their architecture. The rising of the star Sirius marked the flooding of the Nile and the start of a new year. That wasn't a coincidence. Temples were aligned with Sirius so that on specific days, light would shine directly onto sacred statues. At Abu Simbel, twice a year, sunlight pierces the temple's depths, illuminating the seated gods inside. These were not random alignments. Egyptians tracked star paths over generations, recording their movements in star charts on tomb ceilings. One of the oldest star maps ever discovered, the Dendera Zodiac, shows how deeply they connected time, fate, and the cosmos. This wasn't just science. It was belief, power, and prophecy all written in starlight. The alignment of Egyptian monuments wasn't accidental. The Great Pyramid of Giza is aligned almost perfectly with true north with an error of less than 0.05 degrees. That level of precision is nearly impossible, even today. So how did they do it? Some believe they use the circumpolar stars that never set to determine exact directions. Others suggest that they tracked shadow lengths at noon, refining measurements over years. But this wasn't just science, it was also spiritual geometry. The pyramids weren't just tombs, they were cosmic launch pads. The internal shafts inside the Great Pyramid align with the stars in Orion's belt, believed to represent Osiris, the god of the afterlife. To the ancient Egyptians, death wasn't an end. It was a journey, and they believed the stars would guide the soul home. In ancient Egypt, the line between science and myth was thin. The sky wasn't just a place to study, it was sacred. The goddess Nut was believed to arch over the earth, her body forming the heavens. Each night she swallowed the sun, and every morning she gave birth to it again. The Milky Way was seen as her celestial body, a river of stars. And beneath that river sailed Ra, the sun god, in his golden boat. But Ra's journey wasn't peaceful. Each night he battled Apophis, the serpent of chaos in the underworld skies. The stars were not just distant lights, they were divine players in a cosmic struggle. Egyptian astronomers didn't just track the stars, they worshipped them. In Egypt, astronomy wasn't locked in temples or tombs. It shaped daily life. Farmers relied on the stars to know when to plant and harvest. The rising of Sirius wasn't just sacred, it meant the Nile was about to flood. Their entire calendar was based on celestial movements, 12 months, 30 days each, with 5 extra festival days to honor the gods. Priests observed the skies each night, marking star positions with incredible consistency. These observations even influenced temple ceremonies and royal events. Timing was everything. A king's coronation, a pharaoh's burial, even battle strategies all aligned with the stars. To rule Egypt, you had to read the sky. For all we've uncovered, there's even more we've lost. Ancient Egyptian astronomy still holds mysteries. How did they achieve such precise alignments without modern tools? Some believe they used water levels, others think they tracked stars across generations. But no one really knows. Many scrolls were destroyed or buried. And what remains? Just fragments, names of constellations we can't fully interpret. Were they maps of the sky or blueprints of something bigger? Some think the temples and pyramids formed a grand star map visible only from above, a kind of message, not just to the gods, but maybe to the future. We don't know. And maybe that's the magic of it. Egypt didn't just study the stars, it inspired others to look up. The Greeks borrowed ideas from Egyptian priests. Pythagoras, Plato, even Aristotle studied in Egypt. The very idea of the cosmos as order of celestial balance came from these temples. And later, the Romans, the Arabs, even medieval Europe built on these foundations. Astrology, calendars, astronomy all trace lines back to Egypt. Even the concept of a divine ruler connected to the sky echoed in emperors and kings for centuries. Every time we glance up, we follow the eyes of those who once stood by the Nile, charting not just stars, but their place in the universe. The stars above Egypt haven't changed. Thousands of years ago, they lit the path for pharaohs and priests. And today, they shine on tourists and scholars alike. Civilizations rise and fall, but the sky, it remains. A constant memory, a cosmic mirror. The same stars that watched over the pyramids. Oh, watch over us. Maybe that's why we still look up. Not just for answers, but to remember where we come from.